Artificial intelligence has taken over the world. From generating code, game characters, music, and even videos, the next step will be to combine them to create a video game. With the rise of AI, many game developers wonder if it can create a fun and playable game on its own. I wanted to find out and create a game from start to finish without writing a single line of code, and only using assets and sounds that were made by artificial intelligence. The results genuinely blew my mind. I started by asking ChatGPT for a classic game idea that I can make in a few hours, and it just gave me exactly what I was looking for. I decided to go with Flappy Bird, so I asked ChatGPT to suggest me a name for the game. And now, the official making of Flappy AI has begun. I asked ChatGPT what steps to take, and it gave me a surprisingly good 10-step plan to follow. I followed the first step and created a new 2D project in Unity. But step 2 is where things are starting to get interesting. I need to create the sprites for the bird, the background, the ground, and the pipes. But I'm not an artist, so I decided to use an AI tool that generates brand new images based on text prompts. I used a tool called BlueWillow, which is similar to many other tools like Midjourney, Stable Diffusion, and DALL-E 2. I asked BlueWillow to create a 2D sprite of a yellow chick with orange lips, similar to Flappy Bird. And the results were... I wanted a more pixel art look, so I changed my prompt and generated the nice bird sprite that I used in the game. For the background, I used the original Flappy Bird background as a reference and generated a new one. Then I repeated this process for the pipe and the ground. And now we have all the sprites for the game, and we can continue to the next step. I imported all the sprites to Unity, and following ChatGPT's steps, I did the physics components to the bird. Now ChatGPT says to make the bird movement script, but I won't write any code. I told it to write a script for me, and I was thrilled. ChatGPT generated the working, clean code much faster than me. It even added comments to explain each line and documentation at the bottom. Now the bird can move, but the camera won't follow it. I asked ChatGPT to write a camera follow script, and it wrote me a script that smoothly follows the player. All I had to do was tweak the variables. I had high hopes, but the script that ChatGPT gave me made the bird forever move right and will spawn the pipes that will stay still. I wanted to implement it another way, that the bird stays still and the pipes go to it. I told ChatGPT my idea, and it adapted itself and gave me a new script that actually solved my problem. Now we have everything set up, but there aren't any pipes to jump through. I asked ChatGPT how to make the pipe spawn and move to the left, and as expected, it did it correctly. But now I faced an issue where the spawn pipe will move continuously to the left and won't disappear when we can't see them. It can cause lag and a drop in frames per second. I asked ChatGPT for a solution, and it gave me a great answer. Once the pipe goes beyond a certain point on the x-axis, it destroyed itself. I changed the point variable, and the code works perfectly. I continued to ask ChatGPT to implement mechanics in the game, like the bird tilting relative to its velocity. When I had a problem in the game, I told ChatGPT about it, and he came up with a solution, until I asked for a script that only starts the game once the player has jumped once. I tried to run the game, but every time I pressed play, the game froze and I had to restart Unity. The code ChatGPT generated wasn't working, and since I couldn't write any code in this challenge, I had to go back and forth with ChatGPT until the game didn't freeze, which was really frustrating. Next, I made the background and the ground move to give the player a feeling of motion, using a similar technique to the pipes. Finally, to make a game loop, I asked ChatGPT to create a scoring system where the score goes up every time the bird goes through the pipes. ChatGPT generated a code that uses the old UI system, so I told it to rewrite it with a new one, and it did it without any problems. The game was coming along great, and I was very close to finishing it, but two things were missing: music and sounds. I wanted the game to have a retro soundtrack that fits the style of Flappy Bird. I generated a few tracks until I found one that I liked. It was too slow, so I edited it in the studio and increased the BPM. To make the sounds, I use a tool called JFXR that generates sounds based on parameters. I asked ChatGPT to implement the jump, death, and score sounds, and to make the sounds unrepeatable, I told it to play the sounds with a random pitch. And that's it. If you want to play the game on Android, you can download it for free at the link in the description from itch.io. I uploaded the source code to GitHub if you want to check it out. Make sure it's just a proof of concept. The game is playable, but not good by any means. So, will ChatGPT and AI replace game developers? The answer is no, at least not in the near future. The game was made by AI, but it's very basic, and someone without knowledge of programming or game development couldn't make it. As much as AI can help us become more productive, it still cannot replace human creativity. The best way to use artificial intelligence in game development is to use it as a tool to enhance creativity and imagination. So to all game developers, don't fear the rise of AI. Instead, embrace it as a powerful tool to help you create amazing games, just in a shorter amount of time. With the right balance of AI and human creativity, the possibilities of game development are endless. By the way, if you're a game developer, want to learn how to make online multiplayer games that you can play with your family and friends? I've created an online course that will help you learn that. In the course, we will create an online multiplayer race where you collect all the rings as fast as possible before the other player does. We will develop the game step by step, from connecting to a server, joining a match, and syncing the player's actions across the network. By the end of the course, you know how to turn any game idea that you have into an awesome multiplayer experience. It won't be only video lectures. I added different resources to deliver the most engaging learning experience for you, like coding quizzes or the Discord server, where you can join our students' community, collaborate, and even talk and get help from me one-on-one. The reviews have been very positive, and some of my students are implementing what they learned in their Steam games. I created a discount coupon link for you in the description, so if you're interested, be sure to check it out. I genuinely think it's valuable. Thank you for watching the video. I hope it gave you an insight into the role of AI in game development. If you enjoyed it, leave a like. And if you want to see more content like this, be sure to subscribe. Catch you in the next one.